did you have for us tonight?
Today, since Kristin is on the show, I would love to ask you about postpartum depression. Since you treat women with that symptom, then so do you think it is a medical condition, or do you think it's like a cognitive behavior problem?
So I have a hard time separating out medical conditions from cognitive conditions, and then, you know, to me, the brain and the central nervous system are an organ in the body, and so just like any other organ in the body, it can, you know, falter and malfunction. So in that respect, to me, it's medical and cognitive. You know, in pregnancy, our hormones drastically change. You know, we get a bunch of estrogen and a bunch of progesterone, and those two hormones have direct influence on our central nervous system, not to get too medical with everything. But that influences kind of the neurotransmitters and all of the neurological processes and are going on a more biological level in our brain. And once those things are ripped away after a woman has a baby and has a placenta, those hormones are ripped away in our brain as well. And so that really kind of alters the whole chemical balance inside of the brain. And, you know, just in a healthy individual whose brain is functioning normally, it's very common for them to have like baby blues. So I think the 80 to 90% of women experience baby blues where they're just crying at, you know, things that they wouldn't normally cry at, and they're you know, behaviors and emotions are just way off from what they normally are. And so you can imagine in a brain that is already, you know, having some dysfunction, that shift in chemicals would really make things a lot more difficult for them to handle kind of everyday things. And then on top of that, having a new child, especially for, you know, well, any first-time moms or, you know, even second-time, third, you know, having a new way of life and having to adjust to that is a huge stressor, and that in itself kind of increases the risk for mental illness as well.
So the reason I bring up the question is because I grew up in Vietnam, and in my country, I have never seen any women or any person for that matter have sort of like the depression that is like reported by the medical community. And I saw that more often when I immigrated to the U.S. And later on, when I checked the living condition of both societies, I see that in my home country, usually when a woman gave birth, there was a whole support from the family, not just the husband, but, you know, the mother, the father, and the sister, brother, etc. And so I think that probably that's give the woman like a sense of, you know, she's not alone and she does not go through this by herself. And later on, when I came to this country, I read about Stoic philosophy, and basically they said that you cannot control the external environment, but you can control your reaction to or your feelings. And, you know, like Asian people are known to be good at that because they don't have the luxury to seek out, you know, psychologists or psychiatrists to treat their mental issues. So they have to reason themselves out of the problem that they have. So that's why I wonder, you know, like if this problem with women who have depression after birth, is it because, like, you know, the society we're living in is more individualistic, and that gives her a sense like she's had to go through the problem on her own, then that's feed on, you know, the that mindset, and then it intensifies the problem? Or is it really, you know, like there's something like chemically in the brain that caused the symptom worse?
Yeah. So
is that my sentence?
No, absolutely. That definitely makes sense. And to kind of start with the chemical, biological piece of it, you know, whenever we go through any kind of stress, stress, you know, the environment is altered different from what it was, and we're having to adjust to that. There is a biochemical process that goes on in our body where stress hormones go up to kind of, you know, move around different energy sources so that we can manage and deal with the new change in the environment. So having a baby is a stressful situation where our hormones are, you know, our stress hormones are changing, and stress in itself is a risk factor for bringing on mental illness. So when you have a stressful situation, you're already biologically kind of altered in a way that you're more prone to experiencing those symptoms. And then on top of that, to what you're speaking to with our the way that our culture is, you know, we are very individualized, and that's very opposite of what we're used to. So we're very social creatures. Our brain is, you know, has evolved to kind of be used to having that social support. And in other cultures where they have been around their family, they've seen, you know, maybe their sisters have being pregnant and have babies, they've been around their nieces and nephews, they kind of already know what to expect, they know, you know, kind of the different experiences that have gone on. We don't get that in our culture. And then on top of that, you have the baby and then your family's not there. And so not only do you not have the experience already of what it's like to have a baby and what it's like to go through all this, but then you don't have other people around who have gone through that either. And so you're alone in that experience. And, you know, essentially I feel like in this day and age, if you don't have the money to hire people to help you, your mom's working and your sister's working, and really it's nobody but you who can kind of take care of the baby. That would be not only a very stressful situation, but also, you know, isolating. And like I said earlier, our brain is not developed for that.
There's also that stigma around, you know, not being able to do it yourself.
Right.
And there's that, you know, I think as women, we put this expectation on ourselves that we should be able to just do it all ourselves. And really, that's not how we evolved. We did not physically evolve that way, and we did not socially evolve that way.
Yeah.
So I think that's important to remember too, all you women out there.
And I think to kind of speak to, you know, some of the Asian cultures. So I'm part Chinese, I'm half Chinese, and in that culture, you know, it's very much kind of, you know, you don't necessarily talk about it as much, and you kind of, you know, work through it and do it on, you know, get it done. Don't complain. But I think then in the Asian culture, we see a lot more of somatic disorders. And so maybe it's not that they're verbalizing it or it's coming out in that way, but coming out in other ways, you know, your body has to kind of manage those stressors in one way or another. And so that's, you know, another thing that we see with Asian cultures.
So Dr. Kristin, then when you treat a woman who suffer depression, then I guess what I want to know is, like, do you like help, like try to get the help from the family first and try to make them think, like rewire their thinking in a more like positive mode, by like, before you resort to like treating them with medication, right?
Right. So unfortunately, by the time that women get to me, it's usually more severe. So usually their family has already been there and trying to be supportive. Usually the kind of, I'm the last straw, because a lot of women don't want to take medication. And I think for some, it's seen as like a failure, like nothing else worked. And so here I am. So for me, you know, If the family isn't already involved, that's usually because that's not an option, unfortunately.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, Minh,
All right.
Hope that,
yeah.
Well, I was just going to say, I hope that helped answer your questions this evening.
Yeah, that's wonderful. Before I go, I want to know, like, if do you have any, do you write any books or any article I can read on your website?
On my website, I do kind of review other articles that have been written under the Reads section on my website. I don't have time to write other articles yet, but maybe one day.
Okay.